What's up, guys? In this video, I've got a 8.5 ton Trane package unit that we're going to be prepping for installation. It has Symbio. We are going to be installing a few of the controllers here. This one, fresh air options module. I don't know where they're finding fresh air, but we're going to call that outside air. And this should be for our heat. This is the indoor options module. So, and down here we have an economizer. We'll just call it outside air dampers, because even though, yes, it's snowing in Florida currently, it's nowhere near South Florida. But anyways, gotta have that outside air. So we're gonna try and prep this thing for install. I don't know if it's getting installed later this week. This is our second unit we've ordered. First one came damaged. Somebody plowed into it with a forklift and compromised the micro channel. I don't think it leaked or anything, but we just sent it back. Trane delivered it that way. That one is not my job. This is a 25 ton split unit. There's some of our rusty junk. But this unit right here, let's see what this thing is. Looks like a big old outside air makeup unit, something like that. Not my project, but it's here in the graveyard. We already have our main module here. And I think indoor options is gonna go here, and outdoor, whatever they call that, fresh air options. All right, let's get to it. And we're also gonna be installing the electric heat kit, which is here. All right, here's what we got so far. Got dueling compressors. Looks like it's probably wired pretty decent. There's our micro channel. All the real controls are right here. Contactors, transformers, power in. Monitor, electric heater section, we got to cut into there. Some more micro channel, and our fresh air options module is going to go in there. Let's look at our blower here. That's really great. So this is replacing an existing R22 8.5 ton system, and we kept it going as long as we could. It's done, time for replacement. All right, got our heater access open. Just use that cutoff wheel to make quick work of that. And yeah, it's looking like you gotta go through the top to get to that blower. Oh joy. Yeah, I don't think I mentioned it, but this unit's gonna be side discharge. It comes currently set up for downflow, so we are going to probably pull those panels day of installation, because I don't need any critters crawling in this thing, even though they can still get in underneath, but yeah. All right, here's our heating element. It is a 9 kilowatt. There's our heater control box. So we're gonna take this center panel out here so that we can slide that heater in there. All Alright guys, so here's where we're at. We've got our heat kit installed, control panel installed, connected to our contactor, wired in here now. We'll do a little strapping, but option module for the heater is installed. Needed to be addressed to 75, and then work on the outside air. P5 gets hooked up and addressed to 76. So I'm gonna grab the forklift and pull this thing out. I wanna get to that supply side over there, take that side panel off, make sure there's nothing damaged over there since we are gonna be using the side discharge. And we're missing the tabs that hold this up. So I found an empty bag with a slice in it. For now, we're just going to create our own. Around with that. All right, so let me get this buttoned up. We'll pull this thing away and take a look on the other side. All right, I don't know what you guys do, but I went ahead and fixed the option module label. They said to put it out here, but I know what's gonna happen to this thing. It's gonna get sun faded and be gone, so I'd rather just have the information there, put the other one here for the heater. All right, got our panel off, and somebody's already been in here pooping. Probably a raccoon or cats or something. Yep, there's your blower, and it does come out through the top. So it's got those bar frames, pretty heavy duty. But they do make it a little challenging, but like I said, we are doing side discharge. So we should have access to all the screws all the way around, no problem, to be able to lift that off in the future. All right, so I think we're gonna hold off on installing the economizer outside air dampers until we get on site, because where this is getting installed, it's caged in, and it's gonna be nothing but in the way of installing the ductwork, because we literally have a gate right here, and it's metal duct, so sheet metal guys are gonna have to get in there and work, and this will just be nothing in the way. That's it. So I'm gonna wrap this up, park it back in its spot, and bring it back when we do the install. So guys, thanks for watching. There's your Trane Precedent 8.5 ton package unit. Thanks for watching. Oh yeah, find out what this goes to. This is one of our buildings that has three air handlers, and this is feeding the outside air, forcing it in.